running for president here or something? Like, what is it? Like, I just want to party, man.
Like,
what? Climb up with your bumper.
It's not musty good stuff. It's totally, you just put glasses on and go mess with your shit up. Is what that's about.
Oh, what the fuck is that?
Poker face, pa pa poker face, ma 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 ma. Poker poker face, ma ma poker face, ma 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 ma. You a Lady Gaga fan?
Arr, no, don't know who this is.
Are you gonna do this pirate thing the whole time?
Gonna try.
Oh god.
Can't see that lasting too long.
All right, this is when I do the intro. Arr. How's it going, everybody? It's Wine and Cheese. We're here. It's number.
Should be rum and cheese.
Welcome to Rum and Cheese, number 44.
Matey.
I'll see if the YouTube channel will let us change the name. Even if it does, I'm just going to lie to you and say it wouldn't. How y'all doing out there? I know it's a late night, late show. Hopefully I got the old post up there where you can get to the live link now. A lot of stuff going on. Let's just blaze through. Want to give thanks to the wannabes.
Yes,
got a new shipment of stuff in. We'll be sporting it starting next week.
Booty.
But here's what I want to start with, y'all. You'll be seeing it. If you haven't seen it already, you'll be seeing it popping up on Facebook, social media events, anything out there that is interactive social media. I want to talk about Viva La Raza. And you ask yourself, what is Viva La Raza? Well,
Lady Gaga's friend.
I bet you Dave-O has probably met Lady Gaga. So myself and a bunch of other of my family, I like to call them, got a little disturbing news a week or two ago about a really, really amazing human being, person, musician, artist, and just all around great dude, Dave Rosser. He's gonna be getting into a battle, battle that's life-threatening in the next couple of months. It was great to hear from him today that he said he's ready to load the gun up and shoot this.
Fire the cannon.
Shoot this fight in the face. But Dave Rosser, amazing musician. He's played with a who's who in music, but a couple things off the top of my head. Plays guitar for Afghan Whigs, done projects with Annie DeFranco, Mark Broussard, well-known guy and also a beautiful human being. He's gonna be fighting an illness, a life-threatening illness, and we're all getting back together. The family is coming together, and we are gonna be doing an event on November 13th, about 20 days away, at Southport Hall. Southport Hall. We talk about Southport Hall almost
Southport
every week.
Hall.
I mean, not only are they killing it, but they stepped up to the plate again to give us a venue to do this event. It's gonna be My Bam, Paper Chase, The Bag of Donuts, The Chiwis, The Molly Ringwalds, Metal Rose, which is actually Dave-O's band, and our friend again, Mark Broussard, is gonna be stepping in and helping us raise some spirits and some money on November 13th. So I'm gonna let y'all know now, I'm gonna be all Dave Rosser all the time for the next couple of weeks trying to get everybody out there, and so were all my people. So
it's already started tonight, mate.
It's already started tonight, and I can't thank everybody more. It was only a couple of hours ago we launched a page in the event. We're already getting offers for help and money and anything you could think of. So Viva La Rosser, V-I-V-A La L-A Rosser, R-O-S-S-E-R. Find it on Facebook.
Arr.
Like the R-O-S-S-E-R. Do a little background on this guy too. I mean, he really is an amazing cat. And Dave-O,
he's no peg boy. Very nice man.
We fucking love you, brother. And I can't wait to saddle up with you and kick this thing in the ass, brother. So from now on, we're gonna be talking about that a good bit. You don't mind that, do you? If we use some of the showtime to.
Been drinking me rum and it's getting quite late.
So I'll probably talk about it again at the end of the show, but I appreciate it.
Too much.
Too much?
I'm just guessing.
So this is Wine and Cheese 44. How you been, man?
Been okay.
You really gonna do this pirate thing?
I don't know. I'm gonna try.
So being a pirate, I know you live a rough life.
Very much so. What good times, like this weekend with zombies eating sheep.
Well, we're not. How you just gonna go into plugging your band already?
I might mention it again towards the end of the show also.
All right, man, it's.
I learned from you.
I thought I could have made a good 5 minutes with the pirate thing.
Ask away, matey.
Any pain happening in a pirate's life the last week?
Not since all my body parts been replaced by wood. Wood. Teeth, wood. Legs, wood. Wood.
So let me ask you this.
What's that?
You live in South Louisiana.
Right.
Do you have a termite contract on your body since it's all wood now?
No, cannot afford. Pirates don't get a good benefit.
So what if you get some Phimosins that fly in your ear and start eating you from the inside out? What you gonna do about that?
Probably die. Drink more rum.
Well, that's good to hear. Everybody, hope y'all are in the chat room. My boy Scheiss just got here. He's gonna be looking at the chat room. Anything y'all wanna talk about, let us know. But we got a lot to get to. Number one, Tech Nine. Tech Nine was Monday night. Weird time for a show. We went, what'd you think about Tech Nine?
Yes, Monday night, very rough, even for a pirate. I was very tired, but it went in a very good time. I had a great experience. I really like it.
What I think is weird is that you are, not only are you doing a pirate accent,
yes,
but you've got like a foreigner accent.
A fucking pirate sails around cheese, goes to many places, faraway lands, accent is multiple different country, yar.
What type of ship you riding in?
Large, stolen, that was mine.
That was almost an official spit take right
figure
there.
Figure I thought like I'm talking to my grandson.
So last week we talked about Tech Nine, one of my favorite artists from Kansas City, Missouri, the biggest hip hop artist, independent artist in the world. He was at Southport Hall on Monday night.
Southport Hall.
And I gotta say, for me, it was a check on the old bucket list. What'd you think about Tech Nine?
Yeah, it was fucking awesome.
Do you really think?
Yeah, it was fun.
How would you get, first, let's say this, how would you get, you know, you gotta go
away
with that.
You?
No.
If I wear the hat, I gotta do the voice. You want to wear the hat or not to wear the hat?
No.
You decide.
I was fine with it. I mean, I just thought I should, no, leave it down, because we might as well talk for real.
Look, man, I love you. You're in charge here, man.
No,
this is your show.
In charge.
You've stated that multiple times.
So Tech, well, yeah, I mean, until I need graphics.
When
you didn't make a new graphic for this week. I put me hat back on.
It was fun. It was worth going out on a Monday to see. I listened to some of his music. He is talented. And when somebody starts getting tossed around as, even in the internet age, as one of the best rappers around, I have respect enough for the game to go, all right, I want to go check this guy out.
Yeah.
I mean, the last really talented rapper I seen that I was blown away just lyrical-wise was Gift of Gab. When he played with, I think it was Galactic at Tipitina's and Billsbury, honestly. So when I hear another well-skilled rapper is coming, I want to go to see what it was. It was good enough to make it worth. I'm glad I went, you know, even on a Monday. But yeah, I was kind of disappointed in some aspects.
Why is that?
Because he did something that I can't stand about hip-hop or rap shows.
Uh-oh.
And that's the shortening of songs.
Oh, that's one of my favorite parts.
Yeah, see, me, I don't like it.
Really?
So I'm glad somebody likes it. That explains why they do it. But I don't. I'm like, I personally get disappointed. Like, no, I wanted to hear more than one verse from that song. I don't need to hear every song you ever made. That's why Insane Clown Posse impressed me. They did a whole CD, the whole thing.
See,
and that impressed me that they did a song, verse, chorus, verse, chorus. A song is structured a certain way because that's pleasing. All songs wouldn't have those similarities if it didn't work. And then you go live and it's not that, and I just get disappointed.
Well, they do the song and they do the structure. They just shorten it. They leave some of it out there.
Yeah, like a verse, chorus. That's it, and you're on to the next one.
I can tell you this. I fancy myself as a half-ass rapper. Right, and I can tell you this from my point of view, being someone who has gotten up on stage and even though it's cover music, trying to do a rap song in front of people, people don't bore us, get to the chorus. People don't want to hear all that rapping because it's very, a live rapper.
I'm not a fucking person.
No, you are, but what I'm saying is when you're...
Who are these people you're asking that's saying, yes, that's what we want? Half the fucking dumb fucks are going to watch you do anything. They just watch people. That's what they do. You call attention to yourself, they'll watch it. You only got to be moderately, you know, entertaining. They're going to watch it. But other people, I think, who do you ask? Like, I think some people might disagree with that.
I try to take a feeling of the audience that I'm going to, and I could tell that when I ended up, because what I do with Paper Chase, what we do is like, we'll do a song, and what I'll do is I'll chop all the verses in half. So instead of doing 16 bars, we'll do 8 because you're trying to get to the chorus.
Yeah, well, it's different when you're doing it.
What the fuck is that supposed to be?
Probably would want you to jump around too. Like, you know what? If you played half a milkshake, I'd be fucking disappointed.
No. I'd do all a milkshake.
All right.
I'd do all a milkshake. So Tech Nine, I give it
Tech Nine
double thumbs up. It was a
really
bucket list item for me. I really liked it. The people that opened for him,
oh yeah, that was shit.
Wasn't feeling it, was terrible. Well, you did mention Billsbury.
They had a good setup too, like quality shit.
Oh, the light show and the smoke show and all of that stuff. What's that?
I'm gonna roll it.
Let's roll it.
Footage.
Oh yeah.
What do we watch?
Do we have some footage from Tech Nine? All
Tech Nine?
Right, let's see a little bit of footage from Tech Nine. George, just let me know.
This is live from Southport Hall?
Yeah, so this is what we did. We were in, so you could see a killer light show, a killer smoke show.
That light show was good. The smoke was redundant, if I had to complain.
Well, it was like you could see Tech Nine training the audience. They would say what the hook was to the song before they started the song, so they do a call and repeat, and every time the song ended, boom, they would throw the smoke. So I think everybody knows, okay, that's the end of the song, and we're moving on to something else. I think that's a little bit of subliminal messaging.
Yeah, maybe I'm just not a huge, maybe if I was a huge fan, I would have felt differently, but as just the avid watcher and respect for that, I didn't feel like it was that good.
So we ran into Billsbury Flowboy, the winner of the Not Real Radio rap battle. We saw him there.
Yeah, it was almost unfair that dude, any kind of rap game locally, and I don't know, I'd put him against like the heavy hitters. That dude will win or at least put up a damn good fight.
You ever watched the actual, they actually have rap battle leagues and stuff that are
I've seen some of them.
Have you seen some of them?
Yeah.
Here's my opinion on that. Anybody who doesn't know what we're talking about, go on YouTube and watch Rap Battle League.
Yeah, but right? Throw his rap battle lyrics away. To me, that Billsbury's dead. That stuff he did, like when he came on,
that's
you know,
not dead.
Not Real Radio.
It's not dead. It's just,
he's an incredible writer. Like, I've listened to his written works.
Mm-hmm.
They're fucking incredible. He brings that, he can be more creative and make it more complex. I mean, the dude's so quick-witted that now that he's just got this time to just go off and then refine things, his lyrics are incredible.
But
they're
here's the
well
difference.
Delivered.
The battle thing, nationally and what they do worldwide, has turned into this very awful, like, your mama rank out contest.
Yeah.
That's why I even told Billy this one day. I said, you're better than all these guys, but you'd never win because you won't go low enough. These guys all want to talk about shooting you and banging your
not
mom
really.
And all that stuff. But Flowboy is too talented for that, to be honest with you.
Yeah, that's why I like him in the studio writing and starting to make songs. That's
but
funny.
didn't you get the sense that he was a little pissed off?
Yeah, I think it's frustrating as an artist to go and somebody else is on stage doing a not very good job. And we're not talking about tech now. We're talking about some of the openness.
So what we're talking about
is... Even more than him, I think we were disappointed. Like, man, I'd much rather be watching Billsbury right now.
When these national acts come through to a place like Southport Hall, I can tell you right now, my band, Dirtiest Players, I just found out that there's a band coming in February that we've opened before, and I'm already lobbying to open for them. They put...
You know, DP don't even exist.
Sure it does.
Okay.
Sure it does. It does.
We'll see.
We played a good... Head PE is coming to Southport Hall in February. We've opened for them before. I'd like to open for them again. So that's what happens. They put local guys as the openers. To me, there couldn't have been a more blatantly obvious person to open that show than Billsbury Flowboy. And I think he felt the same way. I think he felt slighted. I really do. Like, I got that feeling from him that he was a little pissed.
He got turned down, from what I understand. I don't know how much to go into talking about the business of it, but the hair got stuck in the tape.
Are you talking about the ticket sales deal?
No, like, Southport Hall gets a bunch of bands that they go, we would want these locals to open and to help, you know, with the show. And they got to submit them to the management company of the headliner, and then they look at it and approve somebody. So his name got sent in. It was not like he was looked over. He just was turned down by them, which, for whatever reason, they could have, I don't know. The weird thing about Tech N9ne, after I watched it, I was impressed. I go do a little research, and a big thing with him is that, and there was hardly any black people there, that he hasn't crossed over to black people. He makes a reference to it in a lyric. There's this thing where he's been trying to push to get accepted in the black community so he could feel like, I guess, he conquered that market, if you want to think about it business-wise. I don't know why he's doing it.
What do you think that is?
Important to him because, man, from a business standpoint, it's kind of like, why don't we don't have that market? That's the market we should have. And I think watching a documentary heard something, somebody says that they have money, they're just not spending it on it. And it's not even that they might not like it or something, they just not buy it.
Because isn't that strange? And it's his label is called Strange Music, but you show up to his concert, and if you had to put a percentage on it, I'd say it was 98% white people at his show. Isn't that weird? And he's a African-American artist, always has been. Some reason, his people don't support him and don't like him as much as white folks do. It's his style.
Yes,
I think it's his style.
Once he dyed his hair or would wear paint. They're like, no, that's not how we roll.
They got guitars and stuff in his music. He actually put out a record.
They don't want to see you
three,
do
four
an act.
Years
they
ago.
They want to believe you coming true to them.
Yeah.
Like, they want a political statement, not entertainment.
Yeah, three, 4 years ago, he put out a record that was actually him fronting a metal band. And it's really good. And I'm sure that did a lot more to reduce his credibility amongst those people than anything.
You go back and watch old Bob Marley, you know, stuff. That was, you look out in the audience, a lot of almost all white people. But then you got to realize, too, of the time, like, who's got the money in that area to pay that much for something? You kind of outprice yourself. And not saying all black people are poor, but, I mean, especially around here, there's going to be a divide. To
$30 a ticket on a Monday night. Yeah.
Right.
You know,
you do $15 somewhere down, you know, more New Orleans,
Saint
and you're going to have a totally different crowd and a totally different atmosphere.
Yeah. Well, I'll say this. I give it two thumbs up. Tech N9ne, anybody who hasn't seen him, he's not the Tech N9ne from New Orleans. There is a Tech N9ne rapper, but he came way after Tech N9ne from KC Mo, Kansas City, Missouri. Go check him out. The next thing I want to talk about is something that I did this weekend because I'm proud of it.
Really?
Gaining some momentum. I want to talk about Paper Chase.
Oh, come on.
I'm
things are going
good? I'm on the Paper Chase.
You on that PC high?
Yeah, I am, man.
Really? That's good. You energized.
Right. Because, I mean, we're talking about, we played Gretna Fest. We booked our first fair. We probably played to 5,000 people this weekend. We got Champion Square coming up.
At the Pig Festival?
It's
not a festival.
At the Couchon de Lay, St. Edward's Confessor Fair.
You ever find out what that meant?
Which part?
The Couchon de Lay?
I think it means smoked pig in French. I have no idea. Oh. I didn't ask. I really don't know.
I'll ask next time I'm there.
But a bunch of people, you know, we were supposed to talk about this last week, and you, I knew you had maybe a little sly comment to make. What? How do you, honestly, I want to get your opinion. I mean, this show is about our lives.
Yeah, yeah, fuck these people.
What do you think about me having my band and doing things like fairs, high school fairs, and
or
school
mean?
Fairs? And
how do I feel about it?
I'm just curious what you think about that. You made a comment last week that you thought it was a little ridiculous, maybe.
Oh, it's funny. It's very entertaining to me.
And why do you say that?
Just because, like, I look at you in relation to myself, to where when I look at that situation, I would fucking hate that. That would be horrible for me. And the fact that you go do it, whether you like it or not, it's still entertaining to me. You like going to some weird, crazy fucking place doing something that I would never do. So it's kind of like a vicarious journey that I go on and I get entertainment from it because I do think it's fucking nuts and ridiculous and I would never do it.
You think it's
like the
nuts?
Fact that I can't imagine if
you
I woke up this
you
morning.
You think it's nuts? Hold
on. No, time out. Let me finish.
All right.
I'm going to wake up this morning. I'm going to put on black pants, black button-down shirt, hang pink suspenders off my waist, put a Chinaman's hat on or South African or wherever that originates. And I'm going to get on stage in front of people at a fair and perform this song called Milkshake, where I say my milkshake brings all the boys
to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right, it's better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to,
George. So obviously I have no problem with the song. It's more the suspenders and the Chinaman hat and the fact that I'm jumping around singing it.
You said I was looking better than I ever have.
Right? And it's still fucking entertaining to me. You understand what I'm saying? No, it's not a knock on you. Like, it's amazing.
But you do understand why I did it, though,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah, drugs are expensive. Just give them away.
No, it's a. I'm trying to build a business, and it's an exposure thing.
Yeah, that too. That's entertaining too, a little bit.
So anyway, we played St. Edward's Fair this weekend at the Confessor.
Are you gonna sell milkshakes?
No, the damn band. My band I'm trying to sell.
Right. I thought you were selling milkshakes.
No, I'm not selling milkshakes, but I did see a lot of people we know out there.
Really? How's that Bigo? Feel fun, though, that you're like, oh, Bigo got a great video.
Actually, you want to know what? Sometimes I would, okay, right. You want to get real about this?
Oh, yeah, might as well.
So there were dozens of people that I knew out there, and a lot of them, I know the only reason they were out there was either because they always go to it or they were there to see me. And no, right? They were
look, fuck, it's just funny.
No, they came up, Paper Chase is playing this, let me go see, it's gonna be, I don't know. I really don't care if people think it's ridiculous.
It is ridiculous. That's why it's entertaining.
The way I look at it is, you're gonna sit there and shoot video of me and maybe make fun of it, when the way I look at it is, maybe you just don't have the balls to get up and do what I'm trying to do, and that's create a business and something that could be lucrative and entertaining for a long time.
Jeez, you get on stage and you sing that song, and it's fucking entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
That's the point, yeah.
But it ain't like watching Picasso paint a painting.
Said it was.
Or the orchestra get up there and perform a Beethoven
song. I never said it was. I never said that.
But it's entertaining on that level. He's not making fun of it. He don't have to.
Yeah.
He just got to put the mirror there and let you be entertained by it, too.
Okay, I see what
you're taking
going
it
with.
All negative.
What?
You understand
negative?
What I'm saying?
Well, because then you're being negative.
If you didn't play
you're being negative about it right now.
Not.
You
I'm
are.
Not.
You're telling me to put the mirror in front of my face and see something ridiculous.
You see, that's why you think it looks ridiculous.
It doesn't.
It doesn't look ridiculous to us.
You know, we better move on. We better move.
I never watched you do milkshake and go, this looks fucking ridiculous. No, I've always been like, too busy fucking dancing and laughing.
Well, I will say this. It was the most difficult gig I have ever played by far. Because here's the deal. You get out there and...
What time is it?
We started at 5 o'clock.
In the evening?
Yeah.
So the sun's still out?
Yes.
Oh, God.
Right? Even worse. And we played till 8 o'clock, right? They take a break. We have to take a break.
You did hit the sweet spot at sundown, though.
Oh, yeah. No.
That had to be cool.
It was so good. That's why I had the hat on, because the sun was on me. I can't be out in the
totally
sun that
understand.
Much. And then they tell us, Well, you know, around 7 o'clock, we're going to take a break so the priest can bless the fire and they set the fire and all.
have to cleanse with cheese.
But what you gotta, I'm sorry, somebody was sending me a message. But
hey, can you give him a fucking break?
They were saying it was funny.
You gotta send us that? Okay. We know this shit's funny.
Hey, bro, I'm tense right now, right? There's a lot of shit going on. Viva La Rossa. Like, I'm working on stuff, so don't push me right now. But no, you get out there.
It's not me.
And you go to do your thing, and you grip the mic, and you go to start playing, and you look down, and there's like 50-50 old people and kids. Every song we do has got innuendos and shit. And I look at Woody, and I'm like, he's looking at the set list. He's like, can't do this. Can't do this.
I'm like, why can't Milkshake bring to the bar?
Well, Milkshake made the cut. You know, one of the songs we do is Gin and Juice, and Woody's like, we can't do that here. I'm like, why not? He goes, because the whole song is about getting fucked up and banging chicks, and there's a bunch of 8-year-olds here. So it was
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What the songs did you fucking play? Imagination Movers?
Well, we played almost everything that we usually do, but like, if you were actually standing there watching me do my thing, I'm like, as I'm going to say the line, I'm like, I just stop and let the music play and then pick it up because you can't.
Worry for another day.
Yeah, but that's the thing, man, with these fares, man. You wanna provide a service that they're paying you for.
Yeah, but the parents are driving around in the car listening to B97 playing the songs that y'all played 5 years ago.
I know, I'm sure I way overthink it.
Yeah. Yeah, fuck those kids, you man.
So Paper Chase is my band, and it's a hip-hop, pop cover band. You were asking me about my favorite and least favorite songs to do.
Yeah, I wanted that, to perform.
Yeah, what would be your guess? Because I know you don't know a whole lot of the songs we do. right now, okay, I'll tell you
that's
this.
That's a good one.
Right now. Yeah.
That's my favorite one you do.
I'd say Thrift Shop by Macklemore is my least favorite one
really?
To do. Yeah, because...
You see, I thought you'd like that one. That's a rapping kind of song.
I love the song, but my band has never decided to learn anything to play to it, so they hang me out to dry. You know what I'm saying? The whole song is just Woody going tick, 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 tick. No guitar, no bass playing. Yeah, so it's like...
Like, why? They know the song's on the list, right?
Yeah, they know it.
Nothing.
I don't know, because
you're trying to build a business.
Because just like everything else, I got to pile that on my shoulders and carry it around everywhere.
You're not doing enough.
Yeah, like I'm not doing enough.
Right? Hey, 21 days ain't shit getting done for fucking Paper Chase.
I'm up here in suspenders. I got panties on underneath my pants. Like,
God, you wear two drawers like you wear two shirts?
No, I don't. Nuts. What's my favorite song to do? Let's see. I would say my favorite song to do is California Love by Tupac and Dr. Dre.
Oh, yeah. Your milkshake's way better than that one.
Damn, well, I appreciate
that. You like
doing
that one?
What's that? Milkshake?
No, the other one.
Cali Love? I do. I really like doing that one. And it's one of the reasons.
Is it because you get to go shake it, baby?
Well, that does. I like that. But one of the real reasons I like that, it was the first song that we learned way back when we first started Paper Chase, before this lineup even existed.
So it's easy.
When it was me, Jesus.
You could pretend like you're somewhere else.
No, not easy. It was one of the songs that was like the precipice for the band. It was a song that my buddy David and I loved that you could put that song on at any event. Kids, older, black, white, club, bar, whatever, that comes on, people start shaking it, and it was the first song we learned. So Cali Love, that's my favorite. Right. Yeah. You been paying attention to Lady Gaga?
Hell no, man.
Why not?
What does that mean?
This is something I want to let everybody know.
She ain't been on Netflix, and I'm not Facebook friends with her, so I ain't see her.
Y'all want to know who the number one artist in the world is right now. You can have your Dillinger Escape Project and all that.
They blowing up. I see a lot of that.
Yeah, they blowing up.
Blowing up.
Yeah. Lady Gaga, bro. That's the baddest bitch around
right
now.
That's what you've been digging on? You've been searching YouTube, Lady Gaga?
Well, no. I've always been a big Lady Gaga fan. You want to know when it started?
No.
About 4 years ago, she came on Howard Stern, and she did a song called Edge of Glory, I think, and it was just her and a piano, and that shit was beautiful, and it was badass. So then I started going out and searching her shit out.
digging through our trash.
Yeah, let me look through the gaga.
She ate some of this.
But no, this chick is unbelievable, dude.
Really?
Like, she is an Uber talent, and I think she's finally...
No, it's an Uber driver.
I think she... My guess is that when she was young, she was kind of treated badly and maybe had some bad experiences with men and things like that coming up. So
you can relate to this.
As a young art...
Sorry. I'm being a dick. We're talking about Lady Gaga. What you want me to do?
Well, no, I'm being dead serious that I'm a fan, and I think everybody should really check her out in her stripped down stuff, and she's an amazing singer.
Do you give her money in any type of way?
No.
That's good.
I never have. I will buy her new record, though.
Just more mistreatment from another man.
Yeah, give me that for free.
Hey, call that it.
Run along, honey.
Call that inspiration, bitch.
But no.
They fixed her up. They did some plastic surgery. I
they
seen
did
now
not
she's
do,
doing
you
horrible
see,
pop
you
country
see,
songs.
You see, you're the reason that what? Hillary Clinton is going to get elected president because you're... Because
I'm not voting.
Yeah. Which, oh, we're going to talk about that.
Need more angry white people at the polls.
We're going to talk about that. But no, she was covering herself up with makeup and clothes and meat jackets and shit like that.
Because she was
and
ugly.
No, she's not ugly. She was just ashamed of... her appearance. Now she got the hair pulled back, she got the face going, she got the abs out, the booty.
Undercover check. Muslim.
Did you watch Saturday?
Everything she does is propaganda now. She's trying to infiltrate the American women.
No, did you see her on Saturday Night Live this weekend?
The last thing I seen, the only thing I seen is the one you played where she's doing like a horrible country song or something.
She had a cowboy hat on. That's all
so
you saw. It's
see
not
the
a
scars.
Fucking
hey, regardless, I feel bad that she's getting turned into the run-of-the-mill pop star. Let's put her through the grind now. She's a fucking incredibly talented singer, songwriter, artist. She's weird. I mean, she built the character, and now she's going to get her big payday. And
wait, no. You're like so misinformed. Her big payday already happened.
No, it her ain't. Now she's going to be playing at
she
the Super
sold
Bowl.
Sold 100 million records already.
She plays the Super Bowl real soon. This is the end of our career.
What are you talking about? She's booked on the Super Bowl.
Oh.
Come on, act like you didn't hear that.
No, where the fuck would I hear that?
I mean, all of the 900.
Do you know how much money and time and effort went for you to know what Lady Gaga was up to? Like, she hit every major media outlet. She... Now, of course she's going to play the Super Bowl. This is her big check. And the video you made me watch with her, that ain't what I know of her. Like, maybe I haven't seen everything she's done, but you showed me that, and I wouldn't have known that was her. Her vocal talents, I don't think, even get put into play in that song. That's a pop radio-friendly thing to be played at fairs to children. And it's hard to still be an artist in that aspect. She's going to be sold at Walmart now. You know, with a clothing line or some kind of fucking spray or something. Unfortunately. That's how I feel. Other than that...
As if there's not enough pain in my life.
I'm sorry, it took
you know
Gaga
what I'm saying?
Away. Matey, things get rough when you see. Sometimes you have to throw yourself over.
Anyway, I thought we could do a little something uplifting.
All right,
but
now tell me. Tell me how much you
no,
like
no, no,
it.
No.
You
I really
saw
do.
Her on Stern, right?
See... Well, yeah, and she all did right. a song, Edge of Glory,
and she's
that was
be
about
on the Super Bowl. Like, she we're is... supposed to talk about it. Like, congratulations to them for the marketing media conglomerate that they are.
She's an amazing songwriter.
She's probably on the Slave Nation management, if I would not be surprised.
She's an amazing songwriter, and she's an amazing talent. And there's not another woman alive that's relevant right now that's a better singer than her and a better musician. So, anyway. Go check out what Lady Gaga's doing out there. She did, because she didn't, she, on Saturday Night Live, you know they do
Damn,
two
she
songs.
Did that too.
She did the Ayo, Ayo thing, which was, and then the second one was just her and a piano. And that song was badass. So go check her out. I'll move on now, because, you know, I got Viva La Raza on the brain. And it's really all I can think about. The artist entrance. Anybody who doesn't know what the artist entrance is, it is, I guess you'd call it somewhat of a gathering. It's going to be on Tuesday nights once a month. Our buddy Mr. English from the Terror Twins is putting it on, and it was at Southport last night.
Southport Hall.
You said you were going to come. You didn't come. Once again, you failed.
Here,
no, no, no.
I can't get there that early during the week, man. I'm sorry.
9 o'clock? You can't get there for 9 o'clock?
You told me you were leaving around 8, so I figured that thing was over. It started at 6.
Anyway, you didn't come. You didn't come.
Like, fuck, you tell me. I'm like, all right, we just ate. I'm fucking good.
George,
to go.
How would you describe the artist entrance?
A gathering of art and artists.
Right. It's a
literary and visual and musician.
Yeah, it's a gathering of artists, literary, musical, and vision. I guess that's something we call. And you were saying
visual
before
arts.
Visual arts. You were saying
literary
it's. It's the attempt to create something like you would see in New York, where people would get off of work and then before going home, stop and have a beverage and be able to consume some art or some type of entertainment and see some original artists. It's all original stuff. There's
or
no
be involved in the scene.
Yeah, right.
Like it's a great networking play. I listened to the list of people that you said were there, and that's fucking incredible people. I love being
right
around them.
And I think, you know, I totally expected it to be a flop. I'm not going to, I have to lie.
Really?
I saw
with those
the
people involved.
Well, no. But I saw the, you know, for a bunch of different reasons, there were the couple of weeks leading up, there wasn't enough promotion and things like that for very valid reasons. So I didn't expect it to be a good time. I didn't think a lot of people would come out, but man, I think 30, 40, 50 people came in and out of there.
Oh, that's awesome.
The girl, what was the girl's name that did the art?
Allison France.
Allison France. Look her up on Facebook. She had some art out there. Sold a piece of art
really?
To one
what
of the people
of
there.
What was it? What'd she do?
I think, I mean, look, I'm going to try to describe it. I would call it abstract. Like it's
like sculptures, paintings?
No. Well, she did paintings, but she also had like pieces of art that was more sculpture, but not actually like forming clay. You know what I mean? It was, you know, a whole bunch of tangible stuff. And she did her thing. They had a guy that wrote a book. People bought his book. And I think it was a major success.
That's cool.
Yeah. They want you to come out there and do something.
Who ended up playing?
About 8 different people.
Oh, wow.
They had a guest, the main guest who Rosser was supposed to be, Viva
right.
La Raza was supposed to be the musical guest. He couldn't make it. So they had the guy who wrote the book, was also a musician, and he played. But then you had guys
God,
like Ted Torres.
He wrote the book on it.
Yeah, Ted Torres.
Scott
Freelo.
What, Ginger?
Dickie got up there and did his stuff. So that's what I'm saying. It was
a
nice eclectic group of art. But I'm telling you, they want you to put together, they want you to put something visual together to come out there and be a featured artist at one of these things. What do you think about that?
Dude, I could be a pirate wax figure.
You see, you always gotta play. You're always playing. Why can't you just say that you'll be included in this and you'll put some effort in and come? It's 20 minutes. You do a 20-minute display. Why can't you do that?
20 minutes is hard to stay still, Jim.
No, I'm being serious. Why can't you come be one of the featured artists at the Artist Center?
What do you want me to fucking do?
Well, I think you paint. I think you do visual things.
I'll whip up some paintings real quick. I'll be ready by next month. I'll do that on Mondays before, in between taking a shit and shower. You know what? I'll just start painting while I shit. I'll hang the canvas on the back door, and I'll sit there and freaking shit and paint until I get hemorrhoids so I can be ready for next month.
I mean, look,
that's why, though, really, I don't have anything because it's all gone.
No, okay, I'm going to. This is my show,
right.
So I'm about to break the Czar down for y'all.
Oh, come on!
No. I'm gonna.
I don't have any fucking art. You've been in my house.
No, I have not.
That's smart on my part.
I've never been to your house.
That's right. You never done Not Real Radio.
I'm not trying to. Yeah, you never invited me.
You ain't gonna 360.
You've never invited me to be on your radio show.
Fuck! It's been doing good.
What do you mean doing good?
I don't wanna ruin it.
You're driving listeners away by the fucking dozens on that show. Oh, we get a little tight-lipped. We're a little tight-lipped.
Go fucking look at the SoundCloud. I don't hide my numbers.
Yeah, or neither do I.
Right.
My
I'm
shit's
not
out there.
You of.
Paint his wife white.
It's this show that ruined everything.
You are very self-deprecating, and what you do is you diminish your own skills on purpose, so it's nobody has any expectations. You put all the effort you can in. You think you're a good artist, and you think you're a good painter, and you are, but what you do is you self-deprecate. So when you put that stuff out there, you're saying, oh, I did this, but it sucks, so.
I never said, you know, I said I did a bunch of shit, and I don't have any of it.
Why don't you come out and do 20 minutes?
Because I learned a long time ago, it doesn't matter how I feel about my paintings. If somebody wants it, then they want it, they like it. It doesn't matter. And I would have always just given away my paintings as if it wasn't for other artists getting pissed at me. Like, I started selling paintings, I would just give them away.
Wait. Why would other artists be pissed at you?
Because, man, like, one person told me you're doing way better paintings than me, and I'm trying to sell mine for $20. It's insulting.
They can suck a dick on that.
Sense, though, because how do you judge who gets what? So it doesn't become a bidding thing. It comes first come, first serve, but you got to be willing to also trade it for something. They give it self-worth. Like, they had multiple reasons of why.
You know what? That sounds like a fucking deadbeat artist opinion to me, to be honest with you. That's one thing I can't agree with you with.
I wasn't trying to do a business.
How much do we charge for this show?
What?
How much do we charge for this show? Jack shit.
T-shirt.
Well, yeah, but we'll get to that. Wouldn't you consider this at least some type of art form?
Oh, definitely.
And that's our opinion. That's right. Our point of view. We want to do this, and we want to give it away for free. Where it goes, who knows? We may end up making a dollar one day on this, or we may end up losing our ass on it.
I got it. I'm going to take a laptop. I'm going to play a playlist of the Whine and Cheese Show. And you can go and put on headphones and listen to it.
You see, you just always got to be funny. You just always try to got to be funny. You know what I'm saying? What, you're going to put on headphones?
And listen to a little bit of the show.
I will tell you this, though. You want to know what happened last night? I was there, and Dickie...
It gave you night tremors.
Well, no, Dickie got up there, and he was asking for other people to come up and do stuff. And he goes, geez, you want to come up there and do something?
Oh, no.
I clammed up.
Yeah.
Clammed up. I was like...
My milkshake brings on a bull.
Right, that's the first thing that popped into my head.
Should have done it.
To get up there and do a milkshake.
I would have regretted not going.
But no, I probably have an hour of lyrics that I've written in my head. If for some reason in that venue with 30 people watching, I clammed up.
Yeah, but it's a heavy 30 people. It's not like you're sitting in a room full of peers, not those kids at the fair that just to entertain that you're jumping around.
Yeah, so it was weird. I actually got a little, I was like, ooh. And then I had to go get a beer.
You got nervous.
I didn't get nervous.
Oh, come on, man. What else do you want to fucking call that?
All right, I got nervous.
All right, that's
I got nervous, and I had to shoot it down. But I don't know. Artist entrance next time, I will be up there, and I'll be doing some free form
rap. Oh, really? You serious?
Yeah, I'm going to have Billsbury come battle me.
Oh, God. Artist closed.
Yeah. So anyway, it's going to be a month from now. Don Cooper. You know Don Cooper?
Yeah, I like Don Cooper.
Don Cooper, look.
He hates everybody, me,
no,
but I
he,
like him.
No, he doesn't.
He doesn't like you neither, he told me.
No, I talked to him last night. He likes both of us.
Oh, man.
Unless
what's wrong with that
he either likes both of us or he doesn't have the ability to say I don't like you
to me,
like, right? Like most people. So anyway, I don't care if he hates me or not because his work is impeccable.
He's a good artist.
Right?
Yeah, good.
He's a photographer. Don Cooper, Lazy Eye. Compare those two. Who's better?
Oh, Lazy Eye. Don Cooper's Lazy Eye a couple of years ago, which is not a bad thing to be. Like, and he's out
you
there
think?
Putting forth effort, getting involved in the scene, getting to know. That shows me, like, he's got a good business plan to where he's doing all the things that he needs to. And it's getting his name out there and his pictures out there. And just like Lazy Eye, they continue to increasingly get better and better. And then it's like, wow. Because you know where Don Cooper got a little spark to where I seen a couple of pitches he did, knowing the equipment he's using and how long, you know, he's been doing it, and he goes way faster than the average person who's out there taking pictures.
Yeah. No,
so
I'm...
he's good, man. I'm happy to see him growing.
I'm a total fan.
Happy to see Lazy Eye back in action. Like, I think it's cool.
Did we talk about Lazy Eye last week about the gear and all?
No, I don't think we mentioned it.
Let's go ahead and mention this. I mean, look, we have a forum. We have an audience. Say what you will about the audience. I love you. It's growing every day. We're in that.
Just don't ask nothing
from
them.
Do you see that we're hitting 400 to 500 people every week? How crazy is that? Like, there's...
Yeah, it should be like 4,000, well, no, 40,000.
I agree, and we're wondering how to get to that next level, but I'm happy. We're getting
dressed like a pirate.
Our buddy Zach Luther, Lazy Eye Photography, some fucking asshat went in his car and stole all of his gear. He said it was like $5,000 worth of gear, and I totally believe him because I know the cameras he had and I know the stuff he had, and it really was that valuable. And you talk, you basically, remember what happened when someone drains your bank account?
Oh, yeah. What
did you say? Death penalty.
Yeah.
Death penalty, well, right?
Even worse for him, that was my money gone, but I still had my truck, the ability to go make more money. Like, Doctor Strange is coming out November 4th, right?
Yeah.
He's a surgeon. And he gets in a bad car accident, and he loses the ability to use his hands. And his whole thing is that he had such a steady hand. But, you know, there's machines for that now. But I guess he's from the past.
Yeah.
But he couldn't do surgery anymore, and he loses the ability to use his hands, and he loses his occupation. That was Lazy Eye. I'm like, holy shit. Like, when I thought about it, Allie and I were talking, and I'm like, man, that's like a fisherman losing his boat or his fishing pole.
Exactly.
Like, you gotta help that dude out and, like, to help him get back to be able to make money. It's not about, like, it's worse than just getting money stolen or your car stolen. That's the inconvenience. That's time taken away from you. This is the ability for you to make money, and that had to be a horrible thing. I'm glad to see. I seen him with a new camera.
How did he get that camera?
I don't know.
Can I be honest with you on something?
Uh-oh.
And no, because there's going to be a lot of people who don't
put me hat on.
No, there's going to be a lot of people who probably don't like this, but
oh, good.
Right when, and look, this is just kind of a all-encompassing thing. Right when his gear got stolen, all of a sudden there was this post on Facebook about a benefit, for having a benefit to raise money.
I saw that.
I don't agree with that, man.
Why?
I don't know. It was just something.
Totally fucking
No. It was just
a benefit.
No. Well, I think there's a difference.
Why?
One is battling a life-threatening illness, and one has some gear.
Not eating and fucking not having a place to live and a child, I think, is a life, like, it's not a sickness.
So you think I'm wrong on that?
Yeah. I'd let that one go.
Really?
Yeah.
It's for my best interest?
No, I don't care.
No,
like,
no,
I'm
it's
just saying,
my
if
first...
you're going to devote negative energy to
oh, no, no, no. It's
that,
not geez. Negative energy. It was just my first thought was, it seemed to me like...
You live your life like a candle in the wind.
It seemed to me, and I could be totally wrong, that other people were being vocal about it for their own good. And
fuck,
not,
it's a benefit, man.
No.
Oh.
No, I'm saying, like, other people were saying, we should do a benefit for Lazy Eye and this and that, and everybody was like, blah, blah, blah. And I think everybody was just wanting to comment to make themselves look good. I didn't see any dollars come through. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, I know. Yeah, there was money going to
Was there?
Yeah.
You see, that's I feel good. It was awesome to see that he got a new camera. It's just, I don't know, man. There's some things that you do a benefit for and some that you don't. And
that
struck me as one that didn't, and I could be wrong.
And I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why you're 100% wrong on this.
Okay.
When Lazy Eye was coming up, and you're a struggling band, he's a struggling photographer, no one has any money. So sometimes you might get pictures for free just because, hey, we need to cross market. You got a couple of people. And then you do things for people. Then as you hope that your band and their art grows and it changes at time where, man, like, I look at Tim Lottie coming on our show. He was coming on our show. Comic book artist.
Tim Lottie.
Lazy Eye around the same time. And, man, they took off. And Tim's at New York Comic Con with his own comic book and people dressed up like characters from his book. And he's on the side of the fucking UN with his artwork on the side of a building in the UN on the Wall Street opening. You look at Lazy Eye, and he's doing pictures for the Saints and Louisiana Lottery, and he's like, got good work coming in. You're like, man, that's awesome. And then, boy, I didn't fucking go anywhere. But the phone call is different. Hey, would you like to come on Not Real Radio? I told Lottie at one time, I don't know when, I just stopped even calling him. I felt like I shouldn't. I'm going to text you first and ask for an appointment to call or something.
Yeah.
And it's like, that was so fun and incredible to watch that grow. that that's where the artists were coming together and going, I know this dude has done nice things for me, and if I can help, when I couldn't give him money, now I want to try to at least raise money. Does that make sense?
I hate it when you do that. I really do.
I'm somewhat eloquent.
Yeah, you know, I was talking to somebody about that today that...
No,
because I'm about to say you're right. And I don't mind that. I don't mind being convinced and shown that it's kind of crazy how you can have a... I can have a stance and then a minute later agree with you that I was wrong about that. Because you want to know what? I didn't think about it like that.
Yeah.
Because he did. I saw him for a long time doing stuff for bands for free. Just because, for whatever reason, whether he was practicing or whatever, he was still giving the art away. Yeah. And you know what? Lazy eye, take it back. You need some help, you want some promotion or whatever, you're right.
Call you in 21 days.
Yeah, I'll call you as soon as Viva La Raza is over,
hey, you know,
I'm happy
like
to kick in.
Early in the show, and it happens to us all the time, we talk about a topic and give an opinion on something, we know very little. All I know is that 15-second clip I tried to pay attention to of Lady Gaga,
yeah,
and all that shit I said about her, if that was people that we knew, he would have took a lot of heart into that. If anything, we just think about it yourself, and me included. I do it a lot. I say something on a show, and I go home, and I'm like, did I really mean that? I'm like, no, I think I meant it at the time, but I totally, now that I think about it, don't agree. So
that's it. You know what? That's a good
point.
I think
we learned a good thing tonight.
Yeah.
The show was worth doing it.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So, look, Lazy Eye, you know what? I'm in. You need some help getting your shit back together? I'm down.
Viva La Raza is going to need some
Viva La Raza. Yeah, it will need some pictures. We'll call Don Cooper.
This is far awesome.
No, I'm kidding. But we're getting towards the end of the show. I look, everybody, I don't know how this show is going, but my mind's going in a million different places, so I know we're all over the place. One thing I do...
That thing's like an electric ball.
Yeah, really. It's like a Tesla
like
coil.
Lord Raiden over here. Macho Lord Raiden.
I do want to talk about... you don't do a lot of shows with your band, so when you do them, I want to get the word out there because I think y'all got something going, and I know y'all put the effort in. This Saturday, am I right? This Saturday, Zombies Eating Sheep. Go on Facebook, go on iTunes, SoundCloud, YouTube. Zombies Eating Sheep, that's my boy's band. Y'all got a show coming up Saturday. Where's it at? What can everybody expect?
Dude, it's at Babylon.
Okay.
If you don't know where that at, you probably shouldn't be going.
It's right behind Hooters.
Whatever, don't tell them. I don't want some people there. The place is not adequate to have a lot of people there. I want the right people there. And the right people would be somebody who wants to dress up like a pirate or just a weirdo and come in and just fucking act dumb. Don't act dumb like fucking Insane Clown Posse and be disrespectful to other human beings and destroy stuff, especially other people's property, but come just to have fun. Like, to not give a fuck for just a little while, a couple of hours. Because Halloween to me represents death and transition.
And hot chicks dressing up in booty shorts.
That.
Showing their vagina.
Doesn't hurt. Hopefully it stays moderately warm, right?
Love it.
But I just cut loose and enjoy life and escape reality just momentarily. Like you'll watch Pirates of the Caribbean movie or whatever for 2 hours and escape reality. You can actually escape reality in reality by coming to a weirdo place like this. To where you got freaks, weirdos, beavers running around, you got wizards.
Beavers.
You got all kinds of shit there. And people hopefully dressed up like pirates.
Who else are y'all playing with?
Dude, it's Cerebral Drama, which them in a small area, confined.
Okay, I don't know. Okay, you just lost me.
Really, you don't like them at all?
No.
Oh.
I mean.
You like when Turtle takes his shirt off.
I'll say this. I mean, I have my thoughts about Cerebral Drama.
Right.
I really do. I mean, let's just say this. I like all the guys, and I think they're a good band, but most of me wants to share a stage with them and blow them out the water.
Oh, right.
Because I know we would.
Well, when you get DP
right?
back together, we can have this all
right. And that's what I'm trying to do. But isn't that a little too small for both of y'all to be playing in? The Babylon is the size of like, it's like 10 by 20.
What's wrong with that? We're not playing at the same time.
Well, I understand that, but I think Cerebral Drama's got like six members, and all type of shit, and y'all got tables and stuff everywhere. It just seems like a small venue.
That's just us. We're going to have Ghetto Demon play, too.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Dude, this is Babylon Halloween party. It's come, hopefully, if the weather's
hopefully
nice.
Hopefully, it's spilling out into the parking lot.
Yeah, if the weather's nice,
all.
Man, go hang out, drink a beer in the parking lot. There'll be cool people.
Here's one thing I can tell you.
Three talented acts, three acts that
are too big for
different.
That venue.
Yes. And that's incredible. That's
okay. Well, because I will tell you, Zombies Eating Sheep, Cerebral Drama, Ghetto Demon, that's three acts that I would think were too big for that venue, but you put them in there, let's see what happens, right?
Yeah, and to us, and man, look, if you come, I did some new videos. We put forth a lot of effort. I don't want to downplay the amount of effort we put in.
Yeah, I know y'all do.
But we're going in there with the intent of having fun, though.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sorry you're not going to see an over-elaborate stage show with new... I'm not promising any of that. I'm going to plug in my video to the TV, and we're going to get down and do what we do, kind of scaled down. I kept trying to go bigger and bigger, and it's like, I don't know. I think I was losing something by doing that. I'm looking forward to it.
Just like we did with this show.
It's like, let's
exactly
just have
what
fun
we did with this show, right?
Yeah, let's try
it. Was getting all out there, and then, look, bring it back to what it is, the music,
and
the visuals.
And what you enjoy doing was fun, because the content, to me, is where it's at. And I think that's going to come across really good. Allie and Mayday have been putting in some extra time. Dude, Steve's got to go out of town to a wedding, so we were, like, debating on whether we should play the show or not. And I'm like, you know what, though? Back in the day, the Zombies Eating Sheep ideology
was two of y'all.
If me and Mike could make it,
that's
a show.
It. Done deal.
When we got asked to play, we're like, damn, we do want to play a Halloween party.
Yeah.
And then when it got to be the power party, it's like, all right, this is just for us to go and have fun and goof off. And it's been fun working on it, too. I got some new videos. Steve will be there through the
awesome.
Power of technology. So I'm looking forward to that. It's going to be fun.
Well, Zombies Eating Sheep, your band is on Saturday. Mine is going to be playing on Friday night at Encore. If y'all, it's Paper Chase, y'all want to come out there at Encore, come
is
check it out.
Is it a Halloween
out.
Thing? Or is it just
it is. It's a Halloween
oh,
thing. We'll have a little extra little gear on
oh,
and stuff
come
like
on.
That. Yeah. Makeup. We'll be yeah, doing yeah. the makeup.
You ought
right?
to be Shake from the Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
We do.
My milkshake brings out a ball.
No. I'm dressing up as Raiden from
oh,
Mortal Kombat,
man.
Right? No, I'm not really. I'm doing Jeff Hardy. We do makeup
are
once
you
a year. Yeah. I do Jeff Hardy. We do makeup once a year. Come check it out. The last thing I want to talk about before we get out of here, thank y'all for watching, is the merch, where we come to make that money,
yeah.
right? This is where we get to sell y'all merch and start
in.
Stacking that paper, son. Monday.
They've been so helpful.
Monday, the Whine and Cheese shirts will be here. Last week we showed you the George. Can we get the Whine and Cheese t-shirts up here? Or it's okay. Look, if he gets it up there in the next minute or two, we can. But Whine and Cheese, Mark and I, here we go. Who knows which logo will it be? I gotta give credit to my boy. He created the artwork. It's woo, good lord. Is that a shaded out nipple?
No, it's her knees.
Is that
a can't see the rest of her legs.
Anyway, on Monday, we are going to receive our shirts. We got some a bunch of t-shirts, Whine and Cheese logo on there. They're going to be $20 a piece. Anybody hit me up on the Whine and Cheese page, my personal page. If you want one, we've got small, medium, large, and extra large. So any of your sizes.
Oh, we got fat people sizes?
Well, we got extra large.
Oh, that's for muscular muscle.
Yeah, we didn't
like
go. We didn't
the new
go
neighbors
past that.
Might want some.
Uh-oh. New neighbors. Spoiler alert, we might be getting some new neighbors, but that'll be for next week. But everybody, we're going to be having the t-shirts. No pressure. If you want to rock the Whine and Cheese logo, $20 a pop. If not, it'll just me and you running around in them, and that'll make me happy too.
And we got some for when we get fatter.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm definitely planning on expanding into the XL. as we're bidding you adieu, I just want to say one more time. I can't say it enough. Viva La Rosser. VivaLarosser. Find the Facebook page. Find the event. It's a wonderful human being, Dave Rosser. I think he was actually Whine and Cheese number 18. Anyway, go back on the YouTube channel. I did a podcast with Dave Rosser. Listen to it. Check out, it's a perfect representation of the dude this is. We're going to be doing an event on November 13th, just a couple of weeks away at Southport Hall. $25 minimum donation at the door. Cash bar, food will be available. I promise you, this is an event that is really worth coming to. We're getting together, the family's coming back together to raise some money and some spirits for a great guy. Paper Chase, the Chiwis, Bag of Donuts, the Molly Ringwalds, Metal Rose, and Mark Broussard. What more could you ask for on a Sunday? Y'all come out there on November 13th and celebrate Davo with us. He's going to be there rocking with all the bands. It's Viva La Rosser. You got anything left to say before we get out of here?
NotRealRadio.com, ZombiesEatingSheep.com. Check us out, Babylon, this Saturday, Ghetto Demon Cerebral Drama.
And then Sunday nights, Sunday. The Not Real Radio show is Sunday nights at 8 o'clock. You can find it on MixLR and YouTube and SoundCloud. We'll be talking to you soon. I'll be in your face about this Viva La Rosser. But until then, it's been Wine and Cheese. Thank y'all for hanging out.